Hello everyone, and welcome once again to yet another episode of Achievers Masterclass, where we unravel some mysteries that have to do with the Italian driving theory, you know, lectures. And today I'm your host, and I'll be your lecturer today on this segment as usual. I want to welcome each and every one of you for joining us. I want to thank you for the previous lectures that we've had, that you've been present. Thank you so much. And I also please want to crave indulgence, so as to, you know, if you're a new member in this, you know, seeing my video for the first time, do us a favor by considering, you know, to subscribe with us on this channel, also clicking on the notification bell so that you get, you know, informed as soon as we come live like this, or as soon as we post any subsequent videos in the long run. Alright, if you've not done so already, please subscribe to this channel and then click on the notification bell just to see if you are new, so that you could get, you know, informations on when we come live and when we post our subsequent video. But if you're an oldie, I want to quickly use this opportunity to welcome you, you know, again, thanking you, because you are really the motivation I need to keep on doing what I do. I want to thank you so much, and I'd like you to do us a favor by sharing this video, sharing this live video with your social media community, so that whoever is interested or whoever may have need for such information that you're about to get can have access to it, just like you're doing. Thank you so much. And don't fail to comment on the, you know, video, so that we can see your questions. In case you have questions as the lecture commences, as the lecture progresses, you have any question you want to ask, please do us a favor by dropping those your questions in the comment section, so that I will have the opportunity to explain further the things that may not be so clear to you as regards the Italian driving theory, you know, lectures. Thank you once again as I go ahead to, you know, accept my students from all over the world, those that are registered with us, so that they can join us and be part of this masterclass that we are about to go into. All right, thank you so much. In case you're interested, you want to become one of our esteemed candidates, let us see your comments in the comment section declaring your interest, so that we could put you through on how you yourself can become a candidate and also a student of our platform. All right, let's see your comments, indicate your interest in the comment section, so that we could put you through on how you yourself can become a part and parcel of what you are having access to in a more, you know, in a more informative dimension. Thank you so much, thank you so much for doing this. Today we're going to be talking about the different types of driving licenses we have here in Italy. So as we continue, please pay attention, because you will be needing this information in the long run, as long as you intend to become a driver, or you're already a driver in this country. Okay, talking about the several types, patente di guida, as it is only called here in Italy, patente di guida, sistema sanzionatorio, documenti di circolazione, obblighi verso funzionari e agenti, uso di lente ed altri apparecchi. So these are the things we're going to be treating this evening, and we want to use this opportunity to welcome our students that are coming in from all over the world. Please share this video to your social media community, so that every other person can be accessible to such wonderful informations that are portrayed on this channel. Okay, such wonderful informations. Thank you so much. Recently I've seen, you know, a lot of people, you know, commenting on my videos, saying they are really impressed on what I do. I want to appreciate you, because These are the things that give me the motivation I need to go ahead in doing what I do for my distinguished students. Okay, so that is it. Okay.
Good evening.
Good evening, madam. How are you doing?
Fine.
And how's your
Thank
family?
Blessed.
Okay. Let us quickly go to what we have today. But before we go into it, I want to ask how far you've been doing with your quiz so far. How far have you been doing with it? Have you been encountering any issues? Hello, are you there? Hello? Yeah. I'm listening to you.
Yes, but not that much.
Hello, are you there?
Yes, are you hearing me now?
Okay, I can hear you now.
Okay, I say yes, but not that much.
Okay. That means you've been improving. There are no, the ones you are having issues with are no longer too much like that.
No.
So which, where? Which,
be that time.
Okay, which of the categories are you having issues? Which category of question are you having issues with? Is it pericolo or what category of questions actually?
Divieto.
Okay, yes. can you show me the divieto? From your textbook now, can you show me the video? Let's see if we can tackle it before we enter into what we have for today.
You said what?
Can we quickly go to the divieto so that we can see if we can tackle them immediately? Which of the divieto are you talking about?
Okay.
Where can we find it? The one that the visually is like the traffic light.
Yes.
Okay. Do you know where it is? Where we can find it in our textbook so that we can let's go to Subito and tackle it.
Okay, let me wait. Okay, it's 110.
Page 110. Okay. Okay, I think it's in page 116. Let's go to page 116 because 116 talks actually about, or should I say page, well, yes, page 116. Okay, let's start from 117. Vigile abbraccia aperte, says vigile abbraccia aperte distese verso la nostra direzione di marcia, verso la nostra.
Sorry.
I'm reading from page 117, the last subtopic there. Page 117, go down. Vigile abbraccia aperte distese verso la nostra direzione di marcia. Quando il vigile si dispone con le braccia aperte verso la nostra, verso la nostra direzione, come in figura 3 e 3. Let's go to that 3 in figura 3 e 3. So that you will understand what they are trying to say here. You can see that figure 383 is in page 118. Alright?
Yes, I'm here.
You can see how the vigilant there, the hands of the vigilant is wide open. And the vigilant is facing, it's like the vigilant is facing us now. It's facing you. If you look at it very well, the vigilant is facing you and the arms are open. Now, it says whenever the vigile is like that, è vietato il passaggio e non si può attraversare in croce. Ci si deve conseguenza arrestare prima della striscia traversale di arresto. Non si può neanche svoltare a sinistra, a destra o a sinistra. Now, look at it. You see that this vigile, the arms of the vigile in page 118, the arms are open and the vigilant is facing me, or the vigilant is facing you, according to your book there. What it means is red. It means red traffic, red. It means the red light on the semaphore. When the vigilant is like that, it means red light on the semaphore to you that the vigilant is facing. And also to the people that the vigilant is backing. Vehicles that are coming from that, from the back of the vigilant. You can see that the road is a four-way road. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, the vigilant is in the middle with open arms. It means stop for vehicles that are coming towards the vigilant or that are coming from behind the vigilant. So, at this point, the vehicles that can pass, are the ones that are coming from the right hand side and the left hand side.
Okay.
You understand it now?
Yes.
Those are the only ones that can pass. Those are the vehicles that can pass because now it is stop for you and stop for people that are behind the vigilant. But it is not stop. It is now green for people that are coming from the left hand side or from the right hand side of the vigilant.
Okay.
You understand? You can see the diagram there. You see that the normal picture, the clear picture there, that is beside that figure 383. You see that the vehicle behind the vigilance has already stopped, and there's another vehicle coming from the from up that's in front of the vigilance. There's another vehicle coming in front of the vigilance. All right. So now, if there's another road by the side, left hand side or the right hand side of the vigilance, those vehicles can now move. You understand? And as they are moving, they can follow any direction they want to follow. If they look at the vigilante, if look at the right hand of the vigilante now, any vehicle that is coming from the right hand of the vigilante can either go left or right. The same thing with vehicles that are coming from the right hand side of the vigilante can also go either left or right. I'll come to that. But as long as the vigilante is standing like this, facing you and backing the other side of the road, vehicles that are coming from behind the vigilante and vehicles that are coming from where you are cannot pass. It is a red light for vehicles that are in that position that I've just mentioned. All right, now let's continue. Vigile di profilo con braccia aperte, that's distese orizzontalmente lungo la nostra direzione di marcia. Okay? So now that the vigile is facing me or facing you, you cannot move, and vehicles that are coming from behind cannot move. If you look at it now, vehicles that are also coming from the side, just like I've said, I'm talking about figure 384 now. You will see that the vigilante is still in the same position. But it, even as it is in green light, it is red light for you and vehicles that are coming from behind the vigilante. It is green light. That same position is green light for vehicles that are coming from the right-hand side and the left-hand side of the vigilante. You understand? That is why vehicles that are coming from the right hand side can either go straight, they can go right or left. The same things with vehicles that are coming from the left hand side of the vigilante. They can go left, right, or even straight. If you look at that diagram very well, the diagram of 384, you see that it is there. It is what I'm explaining. Look at the picture beside that diagram. You see that the vigilante that is like that. There is a vehicle coming from the other side. You can see that vehicle. That vehicle has just passed the vigilante from behind. Why? Because it is green light. I don't know if it's clear. It's not clear, I can re-explain. Is it clear?
Yes.
You understand that diagram 384? Ok, now let's continue. Quando il vigile si dispone di profilo con le braccia aperte, come in figura 384, ci è consentito il passaggio e possiamo attraversare l'incrocio, ma usando prudenza. Alright? Now, the vigilante is standing in that position, and we that is coming from the left-hand side and the right-hand side of the vigilante can move. But as we are doing it, we must still do it with care. You understand? We must still do it with carefulness. Inoltre, possiamo svoltare a destra, dando la precedenza agli eventuali pedoni che attraversano la strada traversale, o a sinistra, dando la precedenza a veicoli che provengano di fronte e a eventuali pedoni. What is he saying? As we now that have the green light, as the vehicles that have the green light is going, if they want to turn right, they must also look for zebra crossing and give way for pedone that is on the zebra crossing as they are turning right. Then as they are turning left, you know, I told you that anybody that wants to go left, as you are driving, want to go left, you don't have right of way because you are going left. So as if a driver that is making use that this green light I'm allowed to pass intends to turn left at that junction, you have to give right of way to vehicles that are already passing. It is when they allow you to pass or when there are no longer vehicles coming that you can pass because you are going left. Because you already know that if you want to turn left, if you are driving on any road and you want to turn left, you don't have right of way. It is when you want to turn right that you have right of way. But then, as you are making use of that your right of way, you need to also make sure that the zebra crossing that is on that road is free. If the zebra crossing is occupied by people that want to cross the road, you have to give them right of way as well. Is it clear?
No, I don't understand very well.
Okay. Now, you see that, look at that diagram very well, diagram 384. Look at the arrows on the floor, on the road. The arrow that is pointing, I'm talking about coming when you're looking from the right-hand side of that vigil. All right? When you're coming from the right-hand side of that vigil, you see that there's an arrow on the road there, pointing left, pointing right, and pointing straight. Have you seen the arrow? Hello?
Yes.
You've seen the arrow?
Yes.
Now, since it is green light for vehicles that are coming from that direction, they can either go right because it is, you know, they are coming from that same direction. They can either go right. So if they are going right, if any vehicle that is coming from that direction intends to go right, you understand? If any vehicle that is coming to try to go right, that vehicle must, if there's a zebra crossing there, in that right road that the vehicle intends to enter, the vehicle must, or the driver of that vehicle must give right of way to the zebra crossing that is there. You know that zebra crossing, there are people that usually cross with zebra crossing any road. So as you are entering any road, you must give right of way to vehicles that are, foot users, to pedone, like we do call them, that are already on that road. All right? Now, if the driver, or if there's any vehicle that intends to go left, you know that if you want to go left, you don't have right of way. In any road, as long as you want to enter left, for instance, you are driving now, I intend to take left, you want to enter the left road, you need to indicate that you want to take the left road, but you don't have to just take it immediately as long as the road is busy. If the road is busy, you have to wait until the road is free. That is what I mean by you don't have right of way. I think I've taught you about right of way before. That is when you have to wait. You have to wait so that vehicles on that road can be free, or you can have space on that before you enter because you want to go left. Anyone that is driving on the road and wants to take left road does not have right of way. Okay? You must allow the road users, you must allow vehicles to move first. You must allow vehicles to flow. Vehicles that are on the main road, they must go before you are allowed to make use of that road, or before you're allowed to take left. I don't know if it's clear. I can re-explain with maybe another diagram. If I see another diagram, I will explain. Let me look for another diagram so that because this diagram cannot really cover the explanation that I need to pass across. Look for another diagram. All right, go to page 111. Go to page 111.
I'm here already.
Good. Now, if you look at that road, you see that it's a four-way road, just like this road on page 118, diagram 384. Look at that vehicle that wants to go left. Just look at that vehicle that wants to go left. Now, the semaphore is green. There's a blue vehicle on that road that intends to go right. You see that there are people on that semaphore, on that zebra crossing that is intending to go right. So, it has right of way to go right. If you want to go right, you have right of way. If you want to go right, you have right of way. Alright? Once you want to go right, you have right of way. You don't have any issue going right. But if there's a zebra crossing in that road that you intend to take, and there are people that want to use that zebra crossing, or there are people that are also already using that zebra crossing, okay? Once you see anybody on that zebra crossing, you have to wait. Okay, look at that blue vehicle now, in that page 111 on that road. You see that there are people that are using zebra crossing. The vehicle needs to wait. Yes, it has right of way, but it has to give right of way to people that are pedoni. Do you understand? The one that is going straight, the vehicle that is going straight, this is a perfect example of what I'm trying to explain in the other diagram. The vehicle that is going straight does not have any problem, except there's somebody that is using the zebra crossing of the road that it intends to enter. Then it can then slow down and give them right of way. But since there's nobody ahead, it can continue its journey. But the person that intends to go right, look at people on the road, zebra, look at people on that zebra crossing. Yes, the person, the driver has right of way. The driver has full right of way, all right? But the driver needs to wait for foot users, those that are walking on that zebra crossing. Okay? Now, let's go to the next vehicle that intends to go left. You can see that this vehicle intends to go left. So, any vehicle that is intending to go left on any road must give right of way to the vehicle that is already on that road. Now, look at opposite that road. You see that there's a blue vehicle coming straight. Have you seen it? That blue vehicle that is coming straight, this orange vehicle has to wait for this blue vehicle to pass first. Because this orange vehicle wants to go left, and just like I've said before, if you intend to enter left on any road, you don't have right of way, like the one that wants to go right. As this orange vehicle intends to go left, it does not have right of way, so it has to wait, it has to give right of way to this blue vehicle, so that this blue vehicle can pass first. It is when this blue vehicle has gone, that is when the original vehicle can then enter where it intends to go, or enter that left road. That road it intends to go on the left. I think it's clearer now. Hello? Are you still there with me? Is it clear so that if it's not clear, I can explain again. Just indicate, let me know if it's clear with you. I think we've lost our sister. Hello? Let me know if you are still there so that we can move ahead. Hello? Hello, Mrs. Harris, are you there? You need to respond so that I'll know you are still there. So I don't know, is it clear? If it's not clear, let me know. I want to know that, I want to be sure if you're still there so that I can then continue. I want to be sure if you're still there. Actually, this topic is a topic that it has to be done presently so that you will understand, because most times the diagrams are not really clear. The diagrams are not really clear at all. The diagrams are not really clear. You might not really understand some of them.
Hello.
Are you still there?
Yes, I'm hearing you, but I don't know why.
Okay, from the explanation so far, do you understand what I've explained so far? I'm talking about the explanation on page 111. Okay, then since you understand what I've just explained, let's go back to page 118. Okay, now page 118, you can see what I mean. Vehicle, the arrow on the road there, left, right, and straight. Okay, you now understand the explanation I gave. Vehicles that are going right, if there's zebra crossing there, they need to wait and allow people on the zebra crossing to pass. That is, if there's anybody on the zebra crossing that is trying to cross. But if there's no person on the zebra crossing, then nobody's on. If nobody's on the zebra crossing, then they can just enter directly. But going left is not like that, because if you want to go left, you must give right of way to vehicles that are already on the road, because you are going left. Left does not have right of way. It is right that has right of way. All right. Excuse me. Since you're going left, you have to give right of way to vehicles that are on the road. You understand? So when vehicles on the road have passed, then you can then continue your journey towards the left as you intend to. Then going straight is not any issue, because it is straight ahead. You just go straight. Where there's an issue is going right or going left. Going right is not actually an issue, because once you want to go right, just navigate and go right. As long as there's no zebra crossing there. Or as long as the zebra crossing is free, there's nobody on the zebra crossing, you just need to traffic it and then move ahead. It is when going towards the left that you need to wait, you need to give right of way, because there's no right of way for anyone that intends to go left. Okay. Now let's continue. Let's go to the next one, which is vigilant. I've lost my students. So I guess the network is problematic today. I see the Are you still there? Are you there?
Yes.
I guess the network for today is somehow. Vigile con un braccio alzato verticalmente. Look at diagram 3, 8, 5. You see that the vigile there, the one of the hand, I think the right hand is up and the left one is down. That sign means get ready to stop. Or the yellow semaphore, the yellow light on the semaphore. You know, semaphore have three lights, the red, the yellow, and the green. The red is always above, the yellow is in the middle, and the green is under. Okay? So, whenever you see the vigile in this kind of position, it means that yellow light in the traffic light. That's yellow light in the semaphore, that's what it means. I know that the yellow light is get ready to stop. So as soon as you see the yellow light, the next thing, the last light you're going to see is the red one, which is stop. Okay, so whenever you see the vigilant in this kind of position, it is get ready to stop. Get ready to stop for vehicles that have been moving. You understand? Vehicles that have been moving, the flow that has been moving already. In this case, like this place, that this diagram 384, the green light, you can see that the vehicles that you can see the level of vehicles that are moving. So when the vigil is like this, 385, with one of the hand up and one down, it means that vehicles that have been moving should get ready to stop. Okay.
Stop.
Yeah. Se il vigile ha un braccio alzato come in figura, bisogna arrestarci prima dell'incrocio. Once it is like this, get ready to stop. So as soon as you get to the incrocio, if it is your vehicle that is the last one that gets to the incrocio, you have to stop. Incrocio is the end of that your lane, the end of that lane, okay, or the junction of that lane. Bisogna arrestarci prima dell'incrocio se possiamo farlo senza creare pericolo o rivelarlo velocemente se abbiamo già imparato. Ok, tale comportamento va tenuto sia che si debba proseguire diritto sia che si debba svoltare. Whether I want to go straight or whether I want to go left or right, as soon as the vigile changes position and becomes like this, you must get ready to stop as soon as you reach that incrocio. Questa posizione del vigile equivale alla luce gialla fissa del semaforo. You know, just like I've explained before, this particular position is equivalent to the yellow light in the semaforo. Alright, now let's get to the next one, which is vigile con braccia distese orizzontalmente e ad angolo retto con il braccio destro in avanti. Vigile con braccia distese. Vigile con braccia distese. Braccia distese means, okay, braccia distese orizzontalmente. Open arms. Braccia distese. Open arms. E da angolo retto con il braccio destro in avanti. Now look at this vigilant diagram 386. You see that the right hand of the vigilant is pointing straight in front of it. Then the left hand is pointing by the side. In this kind of position, I wish you could see how I'm positioned right now. The right hand is pointing straight like this. Then the left hand is pointing like this. It is not pointing straight like this. Like this. I believe you can understand what I'm doing now. So that is what it means by angolo retto. Right angle. Okay, the right hand in front, the left hand by the side. So whenever you see this vigile like this, there is something is saying. So let's do it. Il vigile disposto con le braccia ad angolo retto, that's this kind of position, come in figura 386, consente di svoltare a sinistra. Consente di svoltare a sinistra, a destra, o proseguire diritto ai veicoli che arrivano dalla sua sinistra. Now, you see that the this visually, the right hand is pointing straight and the left hand is pointing by the other side. Now, what does it mean? It means that vehicles that are coming from the position where the left hand is pointed are vehicles that can go. And they can either go straight, they can go right, or they can go left. That is why if you look at that diagram very well, you see that the vehicles that are coming from the left-hand side of the police officer of the vigilante there are the only vehicles that are allowed to go. Vehicles coming from the left-hand side. The ones coming from the right-hand side are not allowed. The ones coming from the side are not allowed. The ones coming from behind the vigilante are not allowed to go. Therefore, those ones are red. They are all, it's like their own traffic light now is red. They are maintaining the position of a red traffic light. Why? Because they are the only ones that are not allowed to go. Those that are coming from opposite the vigilante. Vehicles that are coming from behind the vigilante. And vehicles that are coming from the other side of the left-hand side of the vigilante are not allowed. But vehicles that are coming from, yes, of the right-hand side rather. But vehicles that are coming from the left-hand side of the vigilante, coming towards the left-hand of the vigilante, towards. Vehicles that are coming towards the left-hand side of the vigilante are the vehicles that are allowed to move. Whether they are going right, whether they are going straight, or whether they are going left, they are the only ones allowed. Is it clear?
Okay. Yes.
Vieta di proseguire diritto ai veicoli che provengono di fronte o dalle sue spalle, which I've just said before. Vehicles that are coming directly opposite him, or people, vehicles that are coming from the right-hand side, or the elbow side, coming towards the elbow of the vigile. A questi ultimi vieta anche la svolta. Whether they want to go any direction, they are not allowed to move. Okay? Dalle sue spalle a questi ultimi vieta anche la svolta. E ferma i veicoli che arrivano dalla sua destra. Vehicles that are coming from towards or from the right-hand side of the police officer are not allowed to go. Coming towards, coming from opposite, or even from behind, they are not allowed. Only vehicles that are coming towards the left-hand side of the police officer are allowed to go. All right? So, I don't know if it's clear. If it's not clear, I can re-explain. So whenever you see any question that pertains to it now, you will understand and you will get it right.
Yeah.
Good. Now, which other topics is giving you issue in the quiz? I would like us to also take on that one before we enter to this topic. Which other, you know, quiz is giving, which other topic is giving you issues in the quiz when you see the quiz? Which other topics? Hello, are you still there? Hello? Are you still there? Okay. So which other topics are giving you issues whenever you come across the quiz? Like the network is having issues tonight. I'm listening.
Hello?
I'm here.
Are you hearing me?
Yes, I'm hearing you.
This president, the one that I...
Yes, it's like the network is having issues, but I can hear you now. If it continues like this, then we'll have to switch maybe to WhatsApp so that we can continue there. But I can hear you now, actually.
Okay. Is this
you know what happened? Let's switch to WhatsApp. Yes, I think it's best we continue from here because the network is poor.
Hello?
Yes, I'm hearing now. Can you hear me?
Yes, I know you say number 45.
Number 45. Number 49. Page 49. Page 49. Is it Dari Presidenza Nessensi Unici Atanati?
Yes, that 45 and 53.
That 45 and 53, okay. È un segnale di prescrizione. È un segnale di prescrizione, which is also di precedenza. E si incontra una strada a doppio senso, prima di una strettoia. Ok? Prima di una strettoia. Now, what does that strettoia mean? Strettoia means a bottleneck, a road that is, you know, that is not large enough. A road that is not large enough. A road that is, you know, very smooth, it's no longer, it cannot contain two vehicles at the same time. That's what they mean by strettoia. All right? Now, è un segnale di prescrizione e si incontra su una strada a doppio senso prima di una strettoia. Normally, a road is supposed to be wide to contain two vehicles that are coming on the on opposite side. You understand? So whenever you see this sign, it means that the road that is supposed to contain two road users freely, without having issues with each other, that particular road has become smaller, maybe as a result of road work on the road, or bad road, or structure on that road. Alright? So, it has become small. That is what they are trying to say. So whenever you see this sign, just know that it is a two-way road, doppio senso, but it is no longer wide enough to contain the normal free flow it had before on it. Okay. Now, an example, Una parte della carreggiata sbaratta, una parte della carreggiata sbaratta per lavori. Sometimes there's a road that they can be walking on. Maybe there's a road, maybe the road has an issue and they are trying to work on it. It can cause the road to, to reduce in terms of size. Che di norma consente il passaggio di una sola fila di veicoli. Now look at this diagram by the side of it. You see that this diagram, normally it is a two-way road, but because there's a stretoia or there's a bottleneck in front or there's a construction going on in front or there's a structure on in the front of that in front of at the front of the road, you will see that it can no longer successfully contain two vehicles simultaneously. It can no longer contain two vehicles at the same time. That is where this sign comes to play, trying to let us know that look, the red arrow is telling you that the vehicle that is on the position of that red arrow have to give right of way to the vehicle that is in position of the black arrow. Yes. Look at the diagram very well. You see that it has red arrow and black arrow. Red arrow is facing up, black arrow is facing down. So that red arrow that is facing up, it means this vehicle, there's a vehicle on that road now. It is talking about this vehicle or vehicles that are coming on that lane. So since it is red, it means that vehicles that are coming on that lane have to give right of way to vehicles that are coming on the other side, on the opposite side.
Which is the black one?
Yes. So the black one, arrows, the black arrow signifies that vehicles that are coming on the opposite side have right of way. Therefore, vehicles that are coming on the other lane that represents the red arrow have to wait. So that vehicles that are coming on the other side of the road or on the other lane will pass. Is it clear?
Yeah, I understand.
Now, let's continue. Che di norma consente il passaggio di una sola fila di veicoli, senso unico alternato. Obbliga a dare la precedenza ai veicoli provenienti dal senso contrario. Senso contrario means, senso contrario means the opposite side. The opposite side. So you can see that this vehicle is, this road is a two-way road. That means doppio senso. Okay. The vehicles that are on the red, on this lane that represents the red, arrow, have to give right of way to vehicles that are coming from the other side. Okay. Now, moderare la velocità e disporsi a dare la precedenza ai veicoli provenienti dal senso opposto. So, whenever you see this arrow, in some cases, you see that this red arrow might be in the position of where the black arrow is. You understand? So, whenever the position of the red arrow is the position that have to give right of way to the other lane or to the opposite vehicles. You understand? Wherever the position of the red arrow is, in this case, the position of the red arrow is in the right lane for vehicles that are on that right lane. So they have to give right of way by stopping. How do you give right of way to a vehicle? You have to stop for the other vehicle to pass. If you don't stop, the other vehicle cannot pass. So you have to stop. That is how to give right of way. Now, the vehicles that are on the opposite side, which is the black arrow, or the one that represents the black arrow, is for vehicles that are coming on the other side. They have right of way according to this lane, according to this signal here, according to this road sign here. They have right of way. So they will not stop. Why? Because their arrow is already telling them on the other side that they have right of way. Your own signal here has told you that you don't have right of way, you have to wait. Okay, so moderare la velocità e disporsi a dare la precedenza ai veicoli provenienti dal senso opposto perché la circolazione non può svolgersi contemporaneamente, which means the movement can no longer continue at the same time. Why? Because of how the road has become. The road has become smaller. Therefore, the movement, the normal movement can no longer be the same. The normal movement can no longer be the same. The normal movement can no longer be the same. I guess this network is really having, you know, issues, or we are having issues with the network, but let's see how best we can fix it and then move ahead. See how best we can fix it and then move ahead. Okay.
Hello.
Sorry, the phone went off as a result of network. So I guess I have tried to correct it. The most times this house internet is not functional. So I just corrected it. So let's move on. Moderare la velocità e disposi a dare la precedenza ai veicoli provenienti dal senso opposto perché la circolazione non può svolgersi contemporaneamente. Contemporaneamente means together, you know, I've told you about it. Nei due sensi, fermarsi se provengono veicoli dal senso opposto e l'incrocio risulta difficoltoso. Why? Because of this road construction work on the road. Okay, let's go to the next one. I believe the next one is also, you're still having issues with the next one, which is diritto di precedenza nei sensi unici alternati. No. Now, what I want you to take note is their names. This one is dare precedenza. The other one is diritto di precedenza. Now, the first one is dare precedenza. You have to give the precedenza. The second one is diritto di precedenza. Now, you now have rights. Okay? So, as this one is here, let's go back to the first diagram. As this dare precedenza is here, on the other side of the road, on the other lane for vehicles that are coming, they have this one. Is it clear?
Okay. Yeah.
What is in their own lane is this one, which is this number 53, which is diritto di precedenza nei sensi unici alternati. Okay. But because you have this one, since you have this one, they have this one. If you have this one, they will have the other one. If you have 45, they will have 53. If you have 53, they will have 45.
Okay.
You understand? Now, in diagram, in 45 now, direct precedenza, this one you have it. The one you have is 45, which is direct precedenza. The first diagram, which you have, what you have in the first diagram is direct precedenza, in essence, unici alternati. Now, on the other lane, they have 53.
Okay.
Do you understand? Telling them now that they have right of way, which is this diritto di precedenza. Now, on this case, now you have in 53, now if you have this 53 on your own lane, they have 45 in their own lane.
Okay.
Yeah. Now, diritto di precedenza nei sensi unici alternati si trova dall'altro lato della strettoia. You know, I told you, strettoia is that bottleneck. The reason why the road became smaller, the reason why the road became, you know, narrow, is what is called that strettoia. In this case, you can see the reason why the road became narrow, because there's a construction or there's a structure on the road. Okay, now si trova dall'altro lato della strettoia rispetto al segnale numero 45, which is this first one. They are telling you that if you see this diritto di precedenza, that means on the other lane, just like I've explained, on the other lane they have the other one, they have 45. Okay. Now, si trova dall'altro lato della strettoia rispetto al segnale numero 45 e indica che i veicoli provenienti dal senso opposto devono darci la precedenza, just like I've explained. Procedere con cautela anche se abbiamo la precedenza e attraversare la strettoia per primi, dopo esserci però assicurati di aver ottenuto la precedenza dai veicoli provenienti dai fronti. Occorre comunque prudenza. Now, it is true that you have right of way, okay? It is true now that in this case you have right of way, that means you can move. But as you are moving, you have to do it with prudence, you have to do it with cautela, you have to do it with carefulness. Okay, because there are some people, this kind of thing has happened before. I was driving, I was going somewhere before, and there's a vehicle. I have right of way. In this exact case, I have right of way, so I wanted to move, but there's a stubborn driver coming already on that bridge. So what I did was I had to wait. You understand? I have to wait so that he can move with his stubbornness. You understand? So there are some people that are like that. So irrespective of the fact that it is your right to move, you still have to do it with prudenza, because there are some drivers that can just, be stubborn. All right. So I don't know if this too is clear. Is it clear now?
Yes, it's clear.
So take note of the colors. Take note of the colors. Director de Presidência have blue background. Dare Presidência has white background, and they don't have the same shape. Dare Presidência is an oval shape with white background, while Director de Presidência is a square shape, has a square shape with blue background. Okay. So when you see them, you might not know their name, but once you see them, you should know that this is what the sign is talking about. Dare la Presidencia. Is it clear?
Yeah, it's clear. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Are there any other topics?
No.
Okay, go to page 50. I want to explain further what we've just learned now. I want to explain further what we just learned now. Are you in page 50?
Yeah, 50, yes.
Now, I want to explain what we just learned now, the difference between the two of them. The other one is Director de Presidencia, the other one is Dare Presidencia, Dare Presidencia. Now, under Diritto di Presidenza, they said, abbiamo la presidenza se il semaforo è a luce verde. If the semaforo on the road where this on this Diritto di Presidenza is, it says, abbiamo la presidenza. As long as the semaforo is luce verde, abbiamo la presidenza. Also, in the other one, that is Dare Presidenza, Segale 45, abbiamo la Presidenza. If the semaforo is green, okay? Now, the next one is abbiamo la Presidenza se il semaforo è a luce gialla lampeggiante o se spento. If the semaforo that is on that road is or has the blinking yellow light, we have right of way. Okay. Or is off. If it is off completely, or it is blinking, the yellow light is blinking, we have right of way. But on the other hand, dobbiamo dare la precedenza se il semaforo e la luce gialla lampeggiante o se è spento. If it is off, on the other hand, segnale 45, we don't have right of way. We have to give right of way. You understand? The other one is abbiamo la precedenza se il semaforo e la luce rossa, ma la gente del traffico ci ordina di passare. We have right of way, even if the semaforo is red, but there's a traffic agent there that is telling us to pass, we'll pass. The other one is abbiamo la precedenza se il semaforo è a luce rossa, Ma la gente del traffico ci ordina di passare. Now, you know I told you that agente del traffico, which is the vigile that is controlling traffic, is superior to any other traffic light or any other traffic sign. So even if the semaphore is telling, is showing red, if the semaphore is red and a traffic warder or a vigile or a police officer ask you to move, you have to move. So the authority of the police officer is superior to every other signal on the road, whether semaphore or any other one. All right. Now the next one is dobbiamo dare la precedenza. I'm talking about 53 adesso. Dobbiamo dare la precedenza se il semaforo è spento o è a luce verde, ma l'agente del traffico ci ordina di fermarci. If the agente del traffico asks you to stop, even if the semaphore is off, you must obey the agente del traffico, which is the police officer that is controlling the traffic. The same thing with Segnale 45. Dobbiamo dare la precedenza se il semaforo è a luce verde, ma l'agente del traffico ci ordina di fermarci. Is it clear? Good. Now, is there any other one that you want us to, tackle that is giving you issues in the quiz?
Okay, this
Where can we find it?
is 45.
Okay, 45. Okay, confluenza.
Because my problem here is that sometimes I will say this rapper, the record, is the one that have the right to book.
You know, you're talking about the vehicle in that Rampa de Racordo. The vehicle in that Rampa de Racordo, if you look at it very well, you see that there's a giveaway sign there. Now that vehicle in Rampa de Racordo have no business with the Confluenza that is there. The Confluenza does not concern the vehicle at all. It only concerns the vehicles that are already on the main road, vehicles that are on that autostrada. The vehicle that is in that Rampa de Racordo have no business with the Confluenza at all. The only signal that concerns that vehicle in that Rampa de Racordo is that giveaway signal, Dare la Precedenza. That is the only one that concerns it. The Confluenza Destra does not concern it at all. The Confluenza Destra is only on that road telling vehicles that are already on the autostrada, okay, that's vehicles that are already on the autostrada, telling them that look, there's a minor road by the side that leads into this autostrada. So as they are driving along, they must be careful.
Okay, but they don't give way for the vehicle that is down to pass it.
You said?
The vehicle that's on the stand already, is it going to give way? Since you know there is the road there, is it going to wait for the one that's going to come out for the road to pass it?
No. It's not going to give right of way. It's already on the main road. It's already on the major road. The one that is on the Rampa de Racordo have to give right of way, which is that Dare la Precedenza signal that is there. It must give right of way to vehicles that are already on the autostrada.
Okay.
Okay? It must give right of way. The vehicles that are already on the autostrada have no business giving right of way, but they must be careful. because of some, you know, crazy drivers. You know, there are some crazy drivers that that don't take note of all these things. They just have to be careful, but they, that does not mean they give right of way to any vehicle that is coming from the confluence and all. The vehicles that are in the confluence or Rampart de Raccord have to give right of way to vehicles that are already on the autostrada. Very important. Have to give right of way to vehicles that are already on the autostrada. But this confluencer signal that is there is only telling them that look, it's only telling vehicles on autostrada, look, you have to be careful. There's a confluencer, there's a minor road by the side here that vehicles can make use of as they enter the autostrada. So be careful of that, but it's not telling them to give right of way. Let me read on. Preannuncia un'emissione da destra. You can see that this confluenza is a destra. There's another one that is called a sinistra, to confluenza a sinistra. But that one is in rare occasions, considering the kind of road we'll get there now. Preannuncia un'emissione di destra, da destra con corsia di accelerazione. You know, we've talked about corsia di accelerazione. Or, comunque, una confluenza sul lato destro della carreggiata può trovarsi sull'autostrada e comporta il segnale dare precedenza posto sulla rampa d'accordo. Okay? Now this precedenza, this dare precedenza is on the rampa d'accordo. It's not on the main autostrada, is on the Rampart de Raccord, which means it's talking to vehicles, it concerns vehicles that are coming from that Rampart de Raccord that want to make use of the corsia di accelerazione to enter the autostrada. Very well. All right.
Okay.
Good. Now, indica quindi che abbiamo la precedenza su veicoli che si immettono da destra. Ok?
Ok.
Now, it's trying to tell you that abbiamo people that are seeing this confluenza, abbiamo, we that are seeing the confluenza, we that this confluenza is trying to talk to, abbiamo la precedenza. The people that don't have a precedenza is the vehicle that is coming from that Rampart de Raccord. But we that are already on the autostrada, abbiamo
la precedenza.
Yes. Now let's get to the next one, which is confluenza sinistra. Usato su strade che godono del diritto di precedenza. There are some roads that godono. What do they mean by godono? Godono means enjoy. There are some roads that enjoys diritto di precedenza, like this kind of road in this diagram. It enjoys diritto di precedenza because of the kind of condition of that road. Because of the kind of condition of that road, it enjoys diritto di precedenza because of the kind of condition of that road. You will see that this small green vehicle, they have to wait so that the red vehicle can pass. All right? Now, this red vehicle, the confluenza, the segnale for confluenza, there is already telling you that there is a confluenza a sinistra, but the red vehicle have right of way. Now, if you look at the green vehicle, where it is coming from, you see that it has, there's a segnale in there, which is Darella Precedenza. So this green vehicle have to give right of way. The Darella Precedenza does not concern the red vehicle, it only concerns the green vehicle. So this red vehicle has right of way so they can move, but they must do it con precedenza. All right. Let's read. Like this road, they don't have issues at all. All right, they don't have issues at all. Now, as they enjoy their diritto di precedenza, they must also take note that they have to do it with prudenza. Usato su strada che godono del diritto di precedenza preannuncia omissione stradale con corsia di accelerazione posta sulla sinistra o comunque una confluenza sul lato sinistro della carreggiata. Se trova su carreggiata a senso unico, most times, this kind of road, you can only find them a senso unico. Alright? You can only find them a senso unico, this kind of road, you can only find them a senso unico because of the condition of that road. This kind of road, you can't find doppio senso because it's going to be in fact, it's not going to be possible to find this kind of road to be doppio senso. No. It's always senso unico. Okay? Porta il segnale dare precedenza posto sulla strada di missione. I due segnali di confluenza di norma posti 150 metri prima della confluenza invitano la massima prudenza al fine di evitare incidenti. Avoid accidents, to avoid. Potrebbero mettersi nel flusso della circolazione, non ostacolandone l'emissione, anche se abbiamo la precedenza. Even though we have precedence, I'm still need to do it with. Looking at signs. You understand? So, I don't know if this. Two explanations, confluenza destra and confluenza sinistra. I don't know if they are clear.
Yes, it's very.
So, is there any other one? There is no other one. In that case, let's go to what we have for today, which is Patenti di guida. We have several of them. Patenti di guida, sistema sanzionatorio, documenti di circolazione, obblighi verso
Please, which number
funzionari.
is that?
We are talking about page 234. Page 234.
Okay.
Page 234.
I'm
Obblighi.
doing it.
Ok, obblighi verso funzionari e agenti, uso di lenti e di altri apparecchi. Now let's start with patente di guida. We want to talk about the type of different type of patente they have, or different type of patente that are available in Italy here. They have number one, AM, patente AM, there is patente A1, there is patente A2, there is patente A. They have patente B1. They have patente B, which is the one that is common. They have patente BE. Okay. So let's take them one after the other. I also have patente C. Okay. They have patente C. All right. So let's take them one after the other. As time will permit us. Categoria di patente. È vietato condurre autoveicoli. È vietato condurre autoveicoli, motoveicoli o ciclomotori su strada pubbliche se non si possiede idonea patente di guida rilasciata dal competente ufficio, like di motorizzazione in Parma, di motorizzazione in any city, because every city possess or every city have motorizzazione, okay? And this is the office that make available to, people like you and I, this patente, as long as we pass the exam correctly. Whether it is theory or practical, because we need the two. Once we pass the theory, we move on to the next level that has to do with the practical. And as soon as we pass the practical without having any issues, they will hand over that patent to us. So this patent is being, should I say, produced, that means the word, by motorization. In fact, it's a property of the government, and the arm of government that takes care of this patent is the arm of government that is called motorizzazione. Okay? Now, what I've just read so far is telling us that it is not allowed to drive autoveicoli, motoveicoli, or ciclomotori on a public road without having any of this patente that we've seen so far. Without having any of this patente that we've seen so far, it is wrong. It is wrong. It is wrong to drive on a public road. It is wrong to drive on a public road. It is wrong to drive on a public road without patente. Any kind of vehicle at all, very wrong. Rilasciata da competente ufficio. The type, not any type of patente. It must be the kind of patente that is given or that have been released to you from the appropriate office. It must be appropriate office. It must be from the appropriate office. Not from the appropriate office. It's not original. You know. Now, sempre dopo il superamento di specifico esame, like I've explained, le categorie di patente necessarie per condurre autoveicoli leggeri, motoveicoli o ciclomotori sono AM, that is patente AM, patente AM, ok? Patente AM, AM, ciclomotori a due o due e tre ruote, con velocità fino a 45 km all'ora e con cilindrata fino a 50 cm cubici, se con motore termico, se con motore termico. Now, ciclomotori, you know I told you, there are ciclomotori that have two tires or even three, and their speed limit is not more than 45 km per hour. And their cylindrata, that is the cylinders or capacity, engine capacity, is not more than 50 centimeter cube. Okay. Potenza inferiore o uguale a 4 kilowatts. Se dotati di motore elettrico. It is not more than, it must either be equal or even less than 4 kilowatts. Okay, the engine capacity. Now, quadricicli leggeri. O da strada leggeri di massa vuoto fino a 425 kg, esclusa massa batterie per veicoli elettrici, con velocità massima fino a 45 km all'ora e con cilindrata fino a 50 cm cubici per motori ad accensione comandata benzina. Then potenza fino a 6 kW per altri motori termici diesel e per quelli elettrici. Now, this patente AM, I will tell you that it is the smallest. It is the smallest kind of patente. Patente AM, you can use it to drive ciclomotori a due ruote or a tre ruote. You can use it to drive quadricicli leggeri. You know quadricicli leggeri now. They have quadricicli leggeri, they have quadricicli, normal quadricicli. Okay? Quadricicli leggeri is that light one, the one that is not heavy. The total mass is 450, the total weight is 425 kilograms. The cylinder is not more than 50 centimeter cube, you know. And the power, the potenza, which is the capacity, is not more than 6 kilowatts. Okay, so these vehicles that I've just mentioned, the ciclomotori, whether two or three tires or quadricicli leggeri, the for you to drive any of those, you need patente AM. Okay, clear?
Yeah, it's clear. Can I ask for favor?
Tell me.
Go ahead. Are you hearing me?
Yes, go ahead.
Okay, sorry, I don't know whether we can postpone this to next because I'm not the fan.
Ah, very sorry. Sorry about it. There's no problem. Let's postpone it to the next, to our next class, okay?
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. So sorry. Take care of yourself. You know, the weather is becoming so cold, so make sure you're putting on jacket all the time.
Okay, thank you very much.
You're welcome. Take care of yourself. My regards to the family.
Yeah.
Okay. We have come to the end of today's lecture. So, right now, I want to give... We still have, I think, 2 minutes left. For everyone that's been following me so far on YouTube, please, let's